2014 Plus Ram 2500 with the airbags in the back. Ram really hasn't made it easy on aftermarket manufacturers like us with the 2500 with the coil springs, 2500 with the airbags, 3500 with the leaf springs, 3500 with the leaf springs and the air assist. We finally heard from enough of you guys with the factory Ram 2500 airbags that we designed systems for it. I know we're late to the game, better late than never. These systems will fit all the way back to the 2014 plus 2500 so long as it has the factory airbags in the back. We had two main design points here. We wanted to maintain the function of the air ride system, including the alternate trailer height in the back. Additionally, we want to improve the ride and stance of the truck. We'll start you off with the end result. Now worked extensively with both the coil spring and the airbag platforms, and it makes complete sense as to why Ram would offer both. If you're looking for something that rides great on the highway and off-road and has a respectable payload capacity, the coil spring truck is going to be the perfect truck for you. Throw a 1500 pound tongue weight trailer on the back of it and you're going to understand why they made the auto leveling airbag truck. Conversely, if you take that auto leveling airbag truck down a dirt road at 40 miles per hour, you're going to understand why they make a coil spring truck. So there's this connotation with airbags that they ride super soft on road. It's absolutely not the case in heavy duty trucks. Every time an airbag truck will ride worse than a coil spring truck. But if you have to haul, if you never know what load is going to be in the back of that truck, you want respectable off-road capability, you want a great on-road ride, and you want to be able to haul basically whatever you throw in the back of the truck or hitch to the back of the truck within the capacity of the vehicle, and you're not worried about hard charging in the dirt, then the airbag truck is going to be the perfect truck for you. So let's talk function of this rear air ride system and why we did what we did. There's a couple different ways that you can lift an air ride suspension system. There's nothing crazy here. People have been doing this for many, many years. If you want to just get lift, let's say you want a 1-inch lift on the rear. The rear end position is determined by the actuator in the back or the sensor in the back that tells the computer what the ride height is. There's a linkage that connects the axle to this sensor. If you make that linkage 1 inch longer, you're going to fool the rear end of that truck into thinking it's 1 inch lower than it is. So it will effectively pump up the bags to give you the 1 inch rear lift that you were looking for. The problem with doing something like this is, number one, you've shifted yourself 1 inch further down in a travel stroke that may only be 8.5, 9 inches, and effectively lifting the rear is increasing the spring rate. You've pumped air into those bags to lift the rear end, and that increases the spring rate. So you've worsened your ride quality, and you've lost down travel on a platform that's already starved for it, all to basically just get that 1 inch rear lift. The proper way to do it includes a longer link as well as some sort of airbag spacer. The airbag spacer is going to lift the bottom mounting point of that airbag up so that in the new position, the airbag is going to be the same height that it was from the factory. The same height from the factory means the same amount of air in the bag. You have the same spring rate when you do it that way. If you put a spacer on the bottom of the bag, it may now collapse before the factory bump stop. So you're going to have to do something with your factory bump stop, i.e. drop it down into a location where the bag won't bottom out before that bump stop will. Lastly, you've got the link. A lot of guys are taking all thread and threading on some plastic caps because there's really no load on that part. It's just not our style. We don't do things that way. We've got steel ends that snap into the factory position, and then we're going to custom machine aluminum rods here, but all the positions will be set by us. You don't have to worry about adjusting them. They're going to come out of the box ready to go. So that's essentially it for these air ride trucks. They're going to run the same infrastructure as the coil spring trucks, sans the rear coil springs. We're going to be providing you with an airbag spacer to keep that spring rate in check, a longer linkage for your factory sensor to relocate the ride height, additionally, a bump stop drop bracket to ensure that you're cycling that new stroke of travel perfectly without having to worry that you're pinching the airbags because of the spacer. We round all of that off with custom tuned shock packages. No, these are not the same shock packages that we sell for the coil spring trucks. The rear end is shorter travel than the coil spring, so we had to limit the travel out back to make sure that those airbags stay in place. Additionally, the tuning profile is going to be completely different than a coil spring truck. Now let's talk function of the rear air leveling system, because this thing is so badass. I mean, it's not our first go round with an air ride truck. We did this in the 3500, has very similar capabilities, but there's something super satisfying about dropping a 2000 pound pallet in the back of this truck, watching it drop, hearing the compressor kick on, and watching that ride height come back up to normal. You're just ready to go. No fumbling with it, no driving down the road with your headlights to the sky. It's a super cool truck. We've maintained all functions of that rear auto leveling system, including the alternate rear height button. So you've got an alternate trailer height button or alternate load height button in the truck where you press it and it drops the rear an inch when that truck is loaded. This is to either carry the load 1 inch lower in the back if that's something that you want to do, or I guess if you have a trailer that has a tongue that wants to tow a little bit lower than whatever this ride height is, you can accommodate that through pressing this button. Point is, we maintain this function through our system, so you don't have to worry about losing any functionality of that rear air ride system. That was paramount, was keeping its functionality 100% intact. So that's it, guys. I mean, we kind of ran you through what this kit is, why this truck exists, and what we did for it. If you've got any questions for us, hit us in the comments section. Other than that, we'll catch you on the next video, and thanks for tuning in.